And my advanced coursework includes aquatic microbiology, microbial ecology, aquatic ecotoxicology, and environmental regulations. During my graduate career, I worked at the University of Corpus Christi and worked with various contracts that they had with various entities, including the city, and that was mostly related to surface water quality studies. With that said, I want to take a brief moment to thank the city for doing the best that they can to make informed decisions. Because this decision should be no different, I'd like to provide some additional information on waterborne diseases and issues concerning the state statutes and rules. First, as Councilmember Loeb has pointed out, it is very difficult to cite cases of illnesses or deaths specifically caused by someone ingesting water from a residential irrigation system. According to the Center for Disease Control, waterborne illnesses often go unreported or underreported, not because it doesn't happen, but because people don't in the United States do not suspect their public water supply. Rather, they blame the foods that they eat rather than the waters that they drink. And the onset of symptoms can take anywhere from 12 hours to several weeks. So you don't even suspect it was something that you drank 3 weeks ago. Many waterborne diseases are caused by microscopic organisms that are found in the feces of humans, domestic pets, farm animals, domestic and wild birds, such as chickens that we now allow in the city, reptiles and other wildlife. These organisms are so small they can't be seen with the unaided eye. And contamination of the water, or rather the concentrations that cause infection, will not necessarily discolor or change the clarity of the water. So it will appear to be clean. For example, Giardia is a cyst-forming protozoan, and it's just one of many waterborne pathogens. It takes 1 to 3 weeks to incubate. It's the most common intestinal parasite affecting humans. And to put things into perspective, an infected person might shed 1 to 10 billion cysts through their feces daily. And this may go on for several months while you're infected by this disease, but it only takes as few as 10 cysts to cause illness. Infection rates go up in late summer, but this parasite can survive up to 3 months in cold, wet conditions. And would somebody please yield me some time?
Thank you. I appreciate that for respecting.